video for 4810 Winton Road. Here's across the street, neighbor's house. This gentleman was the city's, as you can see, expert on flowers and gardening around the city parks and such. As you can see, it's a very nice area. Spring Grove Village Montessori School, my neighbor's house, a white picket fence, the American dream. They have got two children. They both work at Procter & Gamble. Nice people. Rarely see them. There's their house, which is very much like the same design at 48 Town. Tulip tree in the front of the yard with yellow and orange tulip blossoms in the spring. Here's the house itself. The driveway. Plenty of room for three or four cars. You see that the windows are textured. That allows maximum light with privacy. There's the one entrance the owner does not use. The second entrance the owner does not use. Two-story home. Again, all the windows are treated with no need for blinds or curtains in the house. Plenty of space for a total of four cars. Both sides of the garage belong to this property. Here's a privacy fence. The entry for the owner is in the back of that garage, so he never sees the driveway, but to come through the backyard. And here's his entrance in and out of the house. As you can see, there's good reason. Little pond here, recirculating creek, the water's not turned on currently, gazebo, and all perennials. These are the two rooms that he occupies. One here that has two walls that are all glass, and this room here, which is completely self-sufficient. There's the second floor bedrooms that overlook, and there's the second floor bathroom with the picture window. Now we'll go into the side entrance, which would be a tenant's entrance, either this door or that door, their choice, or for whatever makes most sense with the way the house is being used. In this door, which it goes directly upstairs, however, we'll take a quick look at the basement area. Here are two rooms. It could be used for a guest room or whatever reason. There are two wood floors, carpeted, built up off of the basement floor. Toilet here, steps coming down, two refrigerators down here, either one, a smaller one, and a regular size. Either could go upstairs. Full set of living room furniture down here. There's a redwood Metos sauna. Phones used to be throughout the house, but no longer is that phone system turned on. Laundry, utility tub, and a shower in the basement. So let's head back upstairs. There's also a toilet in the basement. Doing laundry and quick relief works here. So here's the hallway again. There's a light in this hallway here. There are two sconces on the entry to the second floor outside the house. There's an entry here into the first floor kitchen, whereby if the door was put back up, you see the place for the deadbolt right there. That secludes the first floor from the second and can make the second floor a completely private entrance. If the house is shared, here's a refrigerator that's completely empty. That's open for use. There are four refrigerators in the house. Here's a bathroom on the first floor, shower, tub, sink, stove, and again the door that's off on the first floor that would make this an entry private to the second floor if it was put back on, along with a piece of drywall over this archway. Here is the first floor. Chinese oriental rugs with reupholstered antique dining room table to match. Artwork throughout the home. Speaker system, crown molding. That's a 10 by 20 foyer area. Again, you see all the windows are treated. That allows, there's the door that could go in the kitchen. No need for window treatments or blinds. There's a little chandelier that's dimmable there. Speakers in this room, crown molding, large mirrors, leather couch, fireplace, bookshelves, mirrors looking into what could be a dining room. Currently, an office desk is there, copier, artwork on the walls, bowl-shaped chandelier. That is the entry into the pack two rooms that the owner uses that stays shut or could be opened up for sharing the house. But otherwise, that's completely self-sufficient back there. Cooking, refrigerator, air conditioned, and two large rooms suitable for the owner to have complete self-sufficiency in just those two rooms, and has no real reason at this point to use the rest of the house. So it can be shared or the second floor blocked off. There's a ceiling fan in the kitchen here, ceiling fans throughout the house. We just made a circle on the first floor back through that entryway where there could be a door, the archway back into the dining room, living room, and there is the front door that could be used if the house was just opened up and shared completely, entirely. Let's go up to the second floor. You know, we've only got 10 minutes for YouTube here. Headed upstairs. There's a stained glass window, chandelier, the light switch turns it off upstairs. There's a separate switch for this light here. There was one at the bottom of the foyer coming in the side door that we didn't turn on or off. Walking upstairs to the second floor, this light is on the same circuit as the chandelier. Turns off here in the hallway. Little dimmable light here for convenience sake. There's a cupboard here that's mainly been used for towels and soaps and things for the second floor bathroom. There's a window here in the front large room, bedroom, living room, whatever it's made to be. Lots of shelf space, lights in every closet. You see clothes racks, shelving. Lots of closet space. Here's the other closet right across from it. Shelving space, storage area. It's walk-in, relatively large. There's four windows across the front. You see there, half of them are treated, or they don't need window treatment, allowing natural light in. There's an air conditioner in each of the bedrooms on the second floor, being an older, larger home. The central air conditioner does not light the second floor like one might want it to, just being inefficient in a larger, older home. Here's a canopy queen-size bed here. There's the window unit for the second floor in this room. Artwork throughout that could remain or be removed. Rocker, little desk, chairs, plenty of furniture in case someone is short on furniture. The room, the house can be easily fully furnished. Here's the second floor bathroom, which could be exclusively your own. Sink, bidet, white and black ceramic design, tile, new toilet, spa tub, picture window with blinds, however it's completely private, skylight, speakers with a volume control in the bathroom, dimmable lights, heat lamp here, another dimmable light. Here's a picture of the shower. It's nice. Good water pressure. Huh? There's the dimmable lights there in the medicine cabinet. Artwork in the bathroom. Here's the control panel. Volume control for the speaker. Along with remote control switch and all the dimmable lights. Here is the largest bedroom, which used to be two rooms on the second floor, and can be, there's large windows there. This tiled area is set up for a gas stove, gas line running from the basement, and refrigerator can sit in this tiled area. This king-size bed sits in the middle of the room, which is a little bit out of place, but would typically be tucked back into that area. Or a queen-size bed or a single bed. Two more windows with very nice window treatments here that overlook the backyard. Light here, dimmable lights on a track here. Another walk-in closet here. We've got a minute to go. And you see this again, this is walk-in with plenty of shelving space. And walk back out, and this is a dimmable light on a remote control with fan. And there you see it starting, and light dimmer. We've got about 50 seconds, and a big walk-in closet here. As you can see, it is large. And goes back here. That's it, people.